Welcome back. We are still in chapter 4, 4.3, orbital overlap and also hybridization. In this video, we still focus on the formation of hybrid orbitals and also the overlapping diagram. However, in this video, we are focused on the molecule with more than one central atom, or they may have a pi bond. Question number 4a, carbon dioxide. So carbon has 4 valence electrons, oxygen has 6 times 2, so 12 total is 16. So this is the Lewis structure for the carbon dioxide. From the Lewis structure, there are 2 electron domains. So the type of hybridization is sp, but the central atom carbon consists of 4 bonds. Okay, so means that carbon need to have 4 unpaired electrons. So in this case, we will consider carbon as the central atom, while oxygen in this case are the terminal atom. So, then proceed with the carbon round set for the carbon. Carbon is element in period 2, so only consists of 2s and 2p for carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. But just now we already identified that carbon consists of 4 bonds, so need 4 unpaired electrons. But based on the ground state here, only have 2 unpaired electrons. That's why we need to proceed with the excited state of carbon. So one of the 2s electron will electron in the 2s orbital will be excited to 2p. So end up we will going to have 4 unpaired electrons. Then next we are going to have hybrid state of carbon. So because of carbon dioxide consists of 2 electron domain, therefore we only need to hybrid 1s orbital and 1p orbital to form sp orbital. And this time, different from previously, the 2p unhybridized orbital have electron. Okay, so for your information, generally electron in this side, okay, unhybridized p orbital, they are normally will become the pi bond. Okay, while the hybrid orbitals, which is over here, normally will going to form sigma bond. So before we go in details, when we check with the Lewis structure here, first bond between carbon and oxygen sigma, and then pi bond, another side also same. We have 1 sigma bond first and then pi bond. So from here we notice there are 2 sigma and 2 pi bond. So here have 2 unpaired electron which can help you to form 2 sigma bond, and then here also have 2 unpaired electron which can help you to form 2 pi bond. Okay, before we start to draw the overlapping diagram, let's write down the orbital diagram for the hybrid state of carbon, at where carbon have sp, have 2 electron over here, and then 2p orbital is over here. Okay, so the carbon will form the bond with the oxygen, so we're going to write down the ground state for the oxygen. So same case, oxygen also in period 2, so but have 6 valence electron. So 2s, 2p orbital also consists of electron. So basically, we going to know that just now we say sp will going to form sigma bond, and then this one unhybridized 2p orbital will form pi bond. So each oxygen now have 2 unpaired electron over here. One will go into form sigma bond with the carbon, and then another one will form the pi bond with the carbon. So same case happened to the oxygen at the right hand side. Okay, so now we start with by drawing the central atom, which is carbon, with since two orbital, so means that the orbital will going to arrange themselves in linear shape. Okay, so this is sp orbital, one sigma bond, sp orbital, one unpaired electron, and also here one unpaired electron. Then now, this carbon will going to form the sigma bond at the with the oxygen from the 2p orbital. Okay, so this is the 2p orbital sigma bond from the oxygen. I will label 2p over here, also same case, 2p orbital with one lone pair with one unpaired electron form sigma bond. This is oxygen 2p orbital. Okay, so for the carbon dioxide, if we look at the structure here, so sigma bond is done. So now we have pi, another two pi bond haven't done yet. So then we know that for the oxygen, we still have one 2p orbital, while for the carbon, we have two 2p orbital. Okay, so as we already know, these are going to form pi bond. So if we need to form pi bond, means that the orbital will going to overlap side by side, okay, not head by head. Okay, so let's say now we have this carbon have one 2p orbital. Let's say this 2p orbital have one electron, and then this 2p orbital going to overlap the with the 2p orbital from the oxygen at the left hand side here, because they are going to overlap side by side. So that's why you have to make sure these two 2p orbital, they are parallel but with different or opposite spin. So when they overlap like this, this one will form a pi bond. So means that we already center pi bond over here. Okay, then another oxygen also have another 2p orbital which haven't overlap with the 2p orbital from the carbon. So this time the orbital we cannot draw straight as just now 90 degree. We maybe have to draw another way like this. Okay, so this same case happened to here, because as we know, if we draw it straight, so means that we cannot show that the orbital is overlapped side by side. Okay, so this is 2p orbital, and then this one also 2p orbital is this one. Okay, so same case as well, each 2p orbital consists of one electron with different spin. So these two 2p orbital, when they overlap each other, they will going to form a pi bond as well. So now you can see from the Lewis overlapping diagram here, we have two sigma bond, one sigma bond, two sigma bond, and also two pi bond. So this is the overlapping diagram for a molecule with one central atom and also with pi bond. Okay, now let's proceed with one question with more than one central atom, which is HCOOH. This is the Lewis structure for HCOOH. So we use the cluster way, at where we know that hydrogen always have one bond, carbon always have four bonds, and oxygen always two bonds and two lone pair electron. Okay, then we calculate the valence electron. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bonds, so times 2, 10 electrons. And then we have 4 lone pairs, so total is 18 electrons. Then we check, is it enough or no? Hydrogen, 1 valence electron, we have 2 times 2. Carbon, we have 4. Oxygen, we have 6. And then we have 2 oxygen. 12 plus 4, 16. 16 plus 2, 18. So the number of valence electron is correct. So I erase this checking first. Okay, oh no, one of the bond is missing, so replace it. Okay, in this Lewis structure, we notice that there are actually two central atoms. One is carbon, and then another one is oxygen with the single bond. So because they are central atoms, then we need to identify what is the type of hybridization. This carbon have three electron domain, so it's sp2, and then this oxygen have four electron domain, so it's sp3. And then carbon, because it consists of four bonds, so later the orbital diagram of the carbon need four unpaired electron, while for the oxygen only need two unpaired electron because it consists of two bonds. Okay, then now we're going to label the sigma and pi bond in the Lewis structure first. First bond sigma, 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 sigma and pi bond. Okay, so in this Lewis structure, we're going to form four sigma bond and one pi bond. So now we start with the ground state for the carbon element in 2s orbital, sorry, in period 2, so 2s and 2p. 1, 2, 3, 4. Because of here, we say that we need 4 unpaired electrons, so means that carbon need to be excited. Sorry, only have 3 orbital for 2p. So after excited, 2s only have 1 unpaired electron and 2p have 3 unpaired electron. So then we can proceed to hybrid state of carbon. Based on here, the hybridization is sp2, means that we only mix 1s and 2p orbital. So there is left one 2p orbital, but don't forget this 2p orbital consists of electron, which going to help them to form pi bond, and the unpaired electron in the sp2 will going to form sigma bond. Then now we proceed for the oxygen ground state for the oxygen. Again, oxygen is in period 2, so have 2s have 2 electron, and then 2p have another 4 electron. So based on this ground state, they have 2 unpaired electron, which is similar with what we determined just now. Oxygen have 2 bonds, so they're going to need 2 unpaired electron. Therefore, excited state for the oxygen and ground state for the oxygen will be similar. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, then the hybrid, because of consists of 4 electron domain, so the hybrid state is sp3. So each orbital with 2 unpaired electron and 2 non-paired electron. So later, these 2 unpaired electron will going to form sigma bond with the carbon and also hydrogen. Okay, let's gather the information in this slide before we draw the overlapping diagram. This is the Lewis structure for HCOH with 2 lone pair electron and the oxygen. And then we label sigma, 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 sigma and pi bond. So for the carbon over here, just now we already identified is sp2, while this oxygen is sp3. So let's try to come out the hybrid state for the carbon. We're going to mix sp2, so with 3 unpaired electron and 1 unpaired electron at 2p to form pi bond later. While for the oxygen, we're going to have sp3 and then 2 lone pair and 2 unpaired electron. So in this case, we know that this electron is going to form sigma bond. This one also going to form sigma bond. This one going to form sigma, and this one going to form pi bond. Okay, we start with the carbon first. sp2 means that it is trigonal planar, so we draw the shape of trigonal planar first. In the middle here we label carbon, so the type of hybridization for this orbital is sp2. Each of them have one electron. Okay, then from here we know that one carbon will form one bond with the hydrogen, so we try to make this sigma bond first. So this carbon will overlap with the hydrogen, which is fear orbital, to form a sigma bond, 1s hydrogen. And then over here, also we're going to form one sigma bond with the oxygen. So in this case, the oxygen does not undergo hybridization. So the lone pair the unpaired electron is in the 2p orbital. So that's why at here we are going to draw one 2p orbital. Okay, one 2p orbital. This is oxygen, 2p orbital with one unpaired electron going to form sigma bond. So this sigma bond also already done. Next, we are going to form the bond with this oxygen. Okay, so this oxygen saying that here is sp3. So the shape for the sp3 will be tetrahedral. So I will draw the shape of tetrahedral over here. So this is the oxygen, form one sigma bond over here. So level sigma, sp3, 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 sp3. Okay, so this sigma bond also already done. Then here have two lone pair electrons. So I will put two lone pair electrons in the two orbital. Okay. And then this one we have one unpaired electron, so it's over here. Okay, so this one already formed one sigma bond. We still have one electron at the sp3 orbital. So this time, again, based on this Lewis structure, the sigma bond is bonded with the hydrogen. So we use another color to represent hydrogen, just in case you cannot see it clearly. So this one is hydrogen, 1s orbital, so also with one sigma, one unpaired electron, so they are going to form sigma bond. So done for now. Then now, we still have one pi bond, haven't done yet. Okay, so this carbon going to have a 2p orbital, which is over here. Okay, so I use another color. So this 2p orbital, I will going to draw like this. So I label 2p and then with one unpaired electron. And then this oxygen, because they are terminal in term, so also 2p orbital, if you cannot see it, maybe we can try to draw out the orbital diagram for the oxygen. 2s, sorry, 2s, 2 electron, 2p have 4 electron. So just now, this one is going to form sigma bond with the carbon. And then now, this one will going to form pi bond with the carbon as well. So because of pi bond is going to overlap the orbital side by side, so we have to draw the orbital parallelly. Okay, so this one is 2p orbital also with different spin. So because they are parallel, they are able to overlap side by side. So this is the pi bond. So generally, this is the overlapping diagram for HCOOH. Okay, as usual, we need to identify the total valence electron. Carbon have 4, we have 3 hydrogen here, and then nitrogen have 5. So total is 7 plus 5, 12 valence electron. So we roughly already know the idea. Carbon always have 4 bonds, hydrogen 1 bond, and nitrogen always have 3 bonds. So, but here, 3 bonds and 1 lone pair. So after we draw this Lewis structure, we can check the number of valence electrons. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Okay, so the number of electron is correct. So we might we erase this checking. And then here. Okay, then now we go into identify from this Lewis structure. We have the idea that there is two central atoms in this case. One is carbon and then another one is nitrogen. So next we are going to identify the type of hybridization. Carbon have one double bond and two single bond, so three electron domain. So it will form sp2. Same case happened to the nitrogen, one double bond, one single bond and one lone pair, also three electron domain. So the type of hybridization also sp2. But in another condition, we notice that carbon have four bonds, so going to have four unpaired electron, while for the nitrogen have three bonds, so we need to have three unpaired electron. Okay, so we start with the carbon. The ground state of the carbon consists of four valence electron, one lone pair, one pair at 2s, and then two unpaired electron in 2p. Because of here show that we need four unpaired electron, but here only have two, so that's why a cited state is happening. So now, cited state for the carbon. So one of the s electron from 2s orbital will be excited to 2p. Then we'll follow by hybrid state of carbon. So we are going to hybrid sp2, 1, 2, 3. So 2p is okay. So as we already know, sp2 will going to form 3 sigma bond. So when we check at here, 1 sigma, 2 sigma, 3 sigma bond. Yes, correct. Okay, and then we have one pi bond in between carbon and nitrogen. So for hybrid state of carbon is done. Then next we are going to do for the nitrogen. Ground state for nitrogen, again, nitrogen is element in period 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. According to the Lewis structure here, nitrogen have 3 bonds, so going to have 3 unpaired electrons. So in this case, the excited state of nitrogen will be similar as ground state of nitrogen. Then next, going to continue with the hybrid state for the nitrogen. So for the hybrid state of nitrogen, it is similar with carbon, it's sp2. So this time we're going to hybrid s and p orbital, at where they will have one lone pair and then two unpaired electrons at the sp2. So and then from here we have 2p orbital and one single bond. So when we check with the Lewis structure, you will notice that nitrogen have one sigma bond, two sigma bond and one pi bond, and then with one lone pair electron, which is matching with this hybrid state. So now we are going to use the hybrid state of carbon and hybrid state of nitrogen to help us to get the overlapping diagram. Okay, so roughly we already get the idea. Hybrid state for the carbon, sp2 going to have 3 unpaired electron, and then 2p have 1 unpaired electron. Another, this is for carbon. Another condition is for nitrogen, hybrid state for nitrogen, so also sp2, but this sp2 have 1 lone pair, 2 unpaired, and 2p orbital also have 1 unpaired electron. So we start with the carbon. Since sp2, the basic shape will be trigonal planar. So we're going to draw the shape of the trigonal planar. Okay. So sp2. One electron. Okay. So again, maybe we have to draw out the Lewis structure first so that you can see it more clearly. Okay, so two bonds will form with the hydrogen. So as we already know, hydrogen always sphere, 1s hydrogen. Okay, hydrogen, 1s orbital, so sigma. So we already done for this sigma bond and sigma bond. So now we want to form another sigma bond with nitrogen. So this nitrogen also with the trigonal planar shape. So we can draw one over here, trigonal planar. So this is nitrogen. So with one unpaired electron to form sigma bond. sp2. One of the sp2 going to have one lone pair electron like this, and then another one is unpaired electron. So we already settled for the sigma bond and then also the lone pair. So now we proceed with the hydrogen to form this is hydrogen, 1s orbital, sigma. So this sigma bond also done. So now we left the pi bond electron. So the pi bond electron is the element, is the 2p orbital. So because they are going to overlap side by side, so we have to draw the structure parallel. Okay, so what is the color that we can still use? Okay, let's say purple. So this is the 2p orbital. Okay, here we forget to label, this is carbon, 2p orbital with one electron, and then over here also have one orbital, one electron, 2p orbital. So this orbital and this orbital, they are going to overlap side by side to form one pi bond. So we also already settled for the pi bond. So generally, this is the overlapping diagram for CH2NH. Last question in tutorial 4.3, you need to describe the changes of the hybridization for the boron and nitrogen. So as we know, this is the Lewis structure for boron, DF3, with three electron domain. So the type of hybridization, three electron domain, so will be sp2. While for the ammonia, NH3 with three single bond with one lone pair, so consists of four electron domain. So the type of hybridization is sp3. But then for when these two compound, BF3 and NH3 combine, react with each other, they're going to form this compound. So this time now, boron consists of 1, 2, 3, 4 electron domain. While for the nitrogen, also 1, 2, 3, 4. So means that the changes for the boron is from sp2 to sp3. While for the nitrogen, they remain sp3, and then after react with BF3, the type of hybridization is still sp3. So that's all for this question, because they just need us to state the changes of the type of hybridization. Okay, this is the objective answer for tutorial 4.3. So thank you for your time, and we will see you again in next video.